It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hey guys, Tyler here. For the last week, I saw a lot of crazy stories from Spain, and I decided to share the stories with you guys. Before we start, support me through Minds.com and Facebook.com. Unfortunately, my Twitter account was recently suspended. The first crazy story from Spain had a controversy with blackface. On both Twitter and YouTube pages, Russia Today published this clip.
La figura del paje consta de llevarle regalos a los niños desde los camiones donde los tenemos todos recogidos hasta sus casas, subiendo por las escaleras que tenemos de madera o bien por el interior si pesan mucho o no llegan las escaleras.
Para nada es un acto racista, ni es ningún, no tiene ninguna connotación racista, todo lo contrario. Para nosotros, ya te digo que consideramos que es un personaje muy querido y muy valorado dentro de la propia cabalgata, y que si fuera verdaderamente un acto racista, yo creo que todos estos chavales no quisieran participar de este acto.
Due to the publication of this clip, many African Americans have many problems, and of course, they start that Spanish people were racist. So why were many Spanish people in blackface? The answer to that is really simple. Basically, in Spain, they have a celebration called the Three Wise Men. The Three Wise Men, of course, is a reference to the Bible story. In the Spanish tradition, the Three Wise Men are black, Asian, and white. The black one is the most popular, so Spanish people have their face in black to demonstrate their appreciation. Although blackface has a different history in other parts of the world, America had a really bad history with it. Due to things like minstrel shows, blackface was a form of dehumanization for black people in America. They include movies such as The Jazz Singer, A Birth of a Nation, and The Minstrel Man. Personally, I believe that every case of blackface need to be judged by its intentions. If the person has racial intention, obviously it's not okay. However, it's a different story if a person does not have racial intentions. In the case of the Spanish people, they don't have any form of racial intentions. 66% of Americans are white, 12% of Americans are black, and 17% of Americans are Latino. Although Spain has immigration from Africa, it's safe to say that America probably has more black people than Spain. And because they have less black people than us, they have the black makeup. However, due to the internet and computers, they can make people crazy. Speaking about various forms of craziness, the Ministry of the Interior in Spain has a campaign called Stop Radicalism. Basically, if you have information about people or radical messages, you can use their phone number or their webpage. I'm very curious about the conditions of this campaign. First of all, what is the definition of radicalism in their book? Is it criticism of feminism? Is it criticism of Islam? What is their definition? Is it death threats? Is it messages from people from ISIS? What is the definition of radicalism in their book? If there's no clear definition of this, I can imagine a lot of bad consequences. All aggression from a man to a woman in relation to a partner or ex-partner is gender violence. The Supreme Court has established that all aggression from a man to a woman during a relationship should be considered as gender violence. The man has 6 months of prison for the crime of gender violence, and the woman has 3 months of prison for the crime of domestic violence. Acts of violence from a man to a woman constitutes as acts of power and superiority to her, regardless of motivation or intention. Whatever aggression from a man to a woman in regards to a partner or ex-partner constitutes as gender violence. Basically, if a man has actions against a woman, it's gender violence. However, if a woman, it's not gender violence. In America, we have a group of people on the internet called MGTOW, Men Going Their Own Way. Basically, MGTOW are people who don't want dates or marriages or interactions with women. The main reason is because they believe that society is basically against men. Spain has a very serious problem with equality. If men have different laws than women, by definition, is not a form of equality. I don't understand why the Supreme Court of Spain wants this. However, I am not a member of the Supreme Court of Spain. If we want equality between men and women, both men and women need the same laws. Unfortunately, a lot of people are not intelligent. What do you guys think? And until next time, goodbye.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. He's your only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I wouldn't trade him for another black friend. Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware. He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.